Hello, everypony, Dyslexia here. Link to my Divinian art in the description below and also for my Patreon. If you'd like to do that, warning, this video will contain pictures from Google and other places that is not mine, so please go and give respect to the owners of these pictures and copyrights. Also, it's going to contain a lot of spoilers because I have been stupid and seen the episodes to where and back again with from My Little Pony. So if you haven't watched the episodes, this is going to be contaminated with spoilers and things from those two episodes. So if you haven't watched them, I would recommend that you wait or you go and watch the episodes instead of hearing me ramble about, you know, spoilers and stuff. But if you want to hear my opinion about the two new episodes, then here we go. Yeah, 3, 2, 1. So the episode starts with Starlight actually having nightmares going back to her old town because she gets an invite for the Sun Festival or something like that. And first I was like, well, this makes sense because she's afraid that she... the others will not like her anymore, even though that she apologized. I do understand why she have these feelings and why she's afraid of going back and stuff like that. And we also see in the dream what she is fearing, that, you know, maybe they will ask, well, not that they will ask for anything, but they will make her feel unwanted and not needed is the first one. But then she takes the concerns to Twilight and her friends, and Twilight is recommending that she go to the village with a friend. And of course Twilight meant her, but she takes Trixie instead. And I actually likes this I really like this because, you know, Trixie was her first, you know, friend. I know that Twilight also is her friend, but I do feel like she has a stronger connection with Trixie. So I really do feel like Starlight and Trixie makes, it makes more sense, or how to say that. And they go to the festival together, but all of a sudden the ponies from the village is asking Starlight to participate in all of these, you know, things that they want to get done. And Starlight gets very nervous because she don't want to, you know, decide for other people now that she have been the leader before and it didn't go that well. So she is trying to keep low and stuff like that, but it ends with her and, you know, Trixie running away from the Sun Festival and home to Ponyville. But here something in Ponyville is funny. The main six is changed out with changelings. We don't know this at first. First they just, you know, act actually like I would imagine that they would act, but there's still something off on, you know, Applejack and Fluttershy and the others. There's something off, and you know something is wrong. So definitely this was good made. But when she you know, communicates with Twilight, it's a little bit more different. You know, I was actually almost buying Twilight that they hadn't got her yet or something in those lines. But maybe the changelings have studied the main six a little bit better this time before they overtake, and yeah. But the Starlight goes to her room and sleeps, and but she finds out that the others are changelings from a dream that Luna is warning her about the changelings. And here we definitely need some information. Where did, you know, Starlight learn about the changelings? Maybe, you know, Twilight told her or something like that. Okay, yeah, never mind. Smaller details, and it could be explained with, you know, Twilight telling Starlight everything about changelings and Sombra and yeah, everything. So she goes to Trixie and to figure out that she's Trixie or not, she have to speak a certain code. I will not tell the code because I really feel like it's cute, and you know, Trixie has a hard time admitting this code. So yeah, I think it was very funny. But then they find out that the others, all of the main six are now changelings, and they have taken the princesses, and they have taken over the Crystal Empire. They find this out with, you know, Forex coming from the Crystal Empire and from, you know, Starburst, and being like, I'm going to join you because in the Crystal Empire, the, you know, princess there and Flurryheart and all of them are also taken over by changelings. But here Starlight noticed something new about Forex. She noticed that he got new wings and he doesn't seem to have the feed hunger for love anymore. So that was actually very interesting. I was like, what are he eating then? Are he eating normal food now, or can he survive on nothing but air? That's really interesting. But yeah, to get to the point, they join up because they're going to try to defeat the changelings now that they all know that the towns and everything are infested by changelings. And even Discord joins the gang after finding out that the changelings also took Fluttershy. I really thought this was cute, and it definitely fits into Discord's role and stuff like that. I also feel like he is getting closer to, you know, Fluttershy and the other main six. But I would say that he would probably have done it even if it was only, you know, the princesses. I don't know, you guys. I really did feel like it was a little out there, but I enjoyed it. And they find out that they can't go to the hive or to the place where Chrysalis is because no magic outside changeling magic can get to Chrysalis, because she's on a throne that are made from some stone that absorbs you know, magic. And I was like, when I first saw the throne, I was like, oh my god, it's almost like the, you know, Game of Thrones throne, the one with the swords and stuff like that. I was like, no, it's so perfect. But I really did like the design and also the idea concept. Actually, they get an agreement of a password they can say to each other if they got split up or something happens to them that is Clutzy Draconicus, because, you know, Discord falls over a stone and it's hilarious and stuff like that. But yeah, they come into the hive and they start looking for the main six. They have to get rid of some patrols, and without magic it's hard for the others to know what to do. But you know, Starlight is actually taking the leader role, even though that she might not notice or don't like to take the role. She still tells, you know, Trixie what to do, and she tells Discord what to do. I feel like she's also telling Forex at one point what to do, where they switch around the places. So it's Forex that is taken into custody and not Starlight. And I really do like the whole concept about, you know, getting release from for your love, or how to say that. Getting your love out, and so you can enjoy it with each other, and also maybe forgive yourself and, you know, just so you can take in more love and give more love, if that is even possible. I feel like 4X have gotten a lot of love in that small time period that he actually have been good. But yeah, I really did like these two episodes, and I really do feel like it was a full redemption for Starlight. Now we know that she is not, you know, evil and not plotting anything. I really did feel like this is her fully redeemed now, and she have shown that what she's capable of, and, you know, stuff like that. Almost like Twilight, so I definitely feel like more good things is coming for Starlight into the future, but I also hope that they will focus more again on the main six, and it's not going to be, you know, about Starlight overtaking, you know, Twilight's place, or how to say that, because I really, really did not like that. But yeah, maybe it's just me. Please tell me what you think in the comments down below. And do remember that inspiration is right around the corner. Do remember to take care of yourself and your loved ones, and remember to give love. That was actually all that I have to say today. The only thing I don't understand is how can Chrysalis do this as easy as this? At one point, you know, 4X is so infused by the love, so he actually turns into a changeling near Flurryheart. How did she, you know, come so close to Flurryheart without, you know, feeling all of the love, or trying to feed out of her love, or how to say that? Never mind, it's just something I was thinking about. But yeah, that was actually all. Oh yeah, okay, bye.